Hi, welcome to the session on decision analysis. In today's session, we'll be discussing about how to maximize the profit, by taking various decisions. We'll be discussing about different techniques that are to be used to maximize the profit. So the entire topic what we discussed today in today's session is purely based on maximizing the profit. The topic is decision analysis, but the goal is profit maximization. Decision analysis to maximize the profit. Okay. So today we'll discuss about different types of costs before we go into the topics like SMS, AM. The entire topic is based on SMS AM. It stands for S for special order pricing, M for make or buy decisions, whether we should make the goods in-house or outsource the goods. S for sell or further process, A for add or drop a segment or a product line, and M for maximizing the contribution using the scarcity factor, limiting factor, shortage. Okay, so we'll discuss it one by one on SMS AM. Before that, we need to know about some different types of costs. Okay, so we are now going to take decision on SMS AM based on some different types of costs. So the costs will help us to maximize the profits. To maximize the profit in a short run, we should see first of all what problem the company is facing, then develop some alternatives, strategic alternatives in a short term basis, collect the information on these alternatives, and if any information that is irrelevant, that is to be eliminated, and make a decision with the relevant information. Relevant information related to some costs, like opportunity costs. What is the cost which is, what is the benefit which is foregone? What is the cost which is already incurred? What is the cost which is going to be incurred? So keeping in view of these different types of costs, like opportunity cost, sunk cost, and out-of-pocket cost, we need to make decisions. Opportunity cost is the benefit that is foregone by not accepting the another alternative. I give an example here that if the owner of the business is working for the company by resigning his job, where he used to get $20,000 per year as salary, if he is looking after his own office, okay, by resigning the job, so he lost this income. Such an amount is called as opportunity cost. Opportunity cost is to be deducted from the accounting profit. Accounting profit is the difference between revenues minus business expenses. You get accounting profit. These business expenses are called as the explicit costs. Explicit cost means purely related to the business. Once you deduct explicit cost from revenues, you get accounting profit. Accounting profit minus opportunity cost, which we call them as implicit cost. You deduct implicit cost from accounting profit, you'll get economic profit. This is for only analysis purpose for the management, and this is to be presented to the income tax department, various other external reporting. The opportunity cost or implicit cost is not recorded in accounting records. It is only used in a decision making by the economists. Sunk cost. Sunk cost is a cost which is incurred in the past. Sunk cost is a cost which is incurred in the past. And it would be irrelevant in your future decisions because it was already incurred. So here, an example that you bought a car for $10,000 2 years ago. So this 10,000 is a sunk cost because which is incurred in the past. Whether you use it in the business, whether you just park it or you exchange it or you sell it, this is already been incurred. Okay, so you cannot change this cost anymore. It happened already. It is in the past. So the 10,000 you spent on buying the car is sunk cost. And out of pocket cost. Out of pocket cost means the amount which you commit in the future is called as out of pocket cost. Means the cash outlay. Out of pocket cost is nothing but the amount of cash you definitely will have to pay out, like for its insurance or for its repairs, etc., is called as out of pocket cost. Now we know the opportunity cost, sunk cost, and the out of pocket cost. We should also know one more cost called as relevant cost. Now onwards, every decision you take to maximize the profit, we should always question once you accept the decision, what additional cost you are going to incur. That's called relevant cost. Now let us work on SMSAM. Let us begin on this. To begin with, let us take first of all the first letter S. Stands for special order pricing. Special order pricing. Before you accept any special, first of all you need to know some basics. What are the basics you need to know? The basics you need to know include, what is the maximum capacity available? Your equipment, machinery, capital, etc. Say for example, I can produce and sell 150,000 units. This is the capacity I have per month. I can produce and sell 150,000 units. At the moment, I am only producing and selling 100,000 units. Means I am not operating at full capacity. Say for example, I don't have marketing facilities. I do not have enough human resources to do this one, to refill this one. Okay, this is called excess capacity. I have some capacity available if there is a market for my product, still I can produce and sell 50,000 units. Got it? So at the moment, this 150,000 units is the total capacity available. Given a chance, I can produce and sell 150,000. But my company is operating at now 100,000 units. See, 100,000 units fixed cost, say for example, $120,000. $120,000. Whether you produce 150,000 or 100,000, fixed cost will remain same. Whereas variable cost per unit is, say for example, $150 per unit, like direct material, direct labor. Means each unit you produce, you spend $150. So what is the total cost now? When you produce 100,000 units, fixed cost will remain same, 1.2 million, 1,200,000, and 150 times 100, so that is going to be 1.5 million, 1,500,000. So the total cost of producing and selling is 2,700,000. What is the total cost per unit divided by 100,000 units will give us $27. So my total cost is, say, $27. And I'm selling it, say, for example, for $50. a profit. But I feel that there is no market for these products. I have machinery, I have, you know, factory space, I have people even to produce and sell another 50,000 units. Even to produce this 50,000 units, my fixed cost doesn't change. Only the variable cost will respond. Are you getting me? If I produce one additional unit, $150 extra I will spend, but nothing will change in this fixed cost. So I'm just thinking that whether this can be utilized. So I may take some special orders, like from the government or from foreign customer. Okay, so to fill this gap, that 50,000 gap, we got a customer. Say for example, we have got a customer, but what is this? Is I want 10,000 units. First of all, we need to check whether this 10,000 units is within the excess capacity available or not. Yes, I have an excess capacity of 50,000 units. 10,000 units, yes, I can accept, which is within the capacity. Second thing is that, what is the offer price? What is the offer price? Say for example, the customer says that I can buy only for $40. Presently, I'm selling at $50. Now what he says is, there is an error here in the calculation from my side. 15 million plus 1.2 million. It is not 2.7 million. It is 1,620,000. That's what, 16,200,000. 16,200,000 divided by 100,000. So it is going to be 162 per unit. And I'm selling it for 250. Okay, my total cost is 162 and I'm selling it for 250. And one special order, one customer is asking me 10,000 units, which is within the available capacity, excess capacity, but he is asking for, say for example, $200. $200. So first and foremost thing, first what you need to check is whether excess capacity available to accept this order or not. Yes. Second one, what is the special price? Special price is 200. Currently selling at 250, but he is asking for $200. Yes, we can. Why? Because by accepting this, only my variable cost will have impact, but not the fixed cost. Got it. So we can go for this. But we should also check one more point, that is whether any relevant cost is there. Say for example, this customer may ask you to have a special packing or door delivery. He's a foreign customer, so he'll have to deliver these products in his country, so lots of customs etc. will be there. So what is the relevant cost? That you need to check first. What is the relevant cost of accepting this order? Okay, see, every unit I'm getting $50 of profit because the offer price is 200 and 150 is my cost, $50. So $50 times 10,000 units of order, I will get 500,000. Okay, say for example, relevant cost, we paid $300,000 to a salesperson who executed this order because he's a foreign customer, and there is a custom charge of say 210,000. So the total cost is 510,000. Though it is giving us an additional profit of 500,000, if of no use accepting this, the relevant cost is more. No, say for example, only the relevant cost is 30,000. We pay commission to the salesperson, and there will be, say for example, a customs amount of 20,000. Total is 50,000. My additional income is 500,000. My additional cost of accepting this order is 50,000. So I can still make a profit of 450,000. This way I can accept this order. But fourth point is a non-financial issue. What is it? See, this customer, as I've been telling you, that is a special order, one-time order. Okay, you may not buy it again, or else this order may be from the government. They don't sell the goods. It is you for their consumption, so that there will be no competition to your existing customers. Yeah, or I said a foreign customer. What happens if you sell it to the domestic customer? The domestic customer who purchased this 10,000 units at $200 may become competitor to your existing customers who have been buying from you this 100,000 units at 250. Obviously, they will be selling at 250 plus something. Your customers are buying from you at 250, they might be selling at 280. But this special order customer is buying from you at 200, he may sell at 230. So you'll become a tough competitor to your existing customers. Then existing customers may raise a point that how can our competitor can buy from you at lower price and selling it out less than our cost price. See, our existing cost price is $250, is buying from you at 250, but this customer is buying from you at 200, he might be selling at 230, which is less than his cost price. So that may affect your existing business. That is a non-financial issue. So you need to remember these 4 points before you accept a special order pricing. Let's have a recap again. First point, whether we have excess capacity available or not. Second point, whether the special order price is covering your variable cost or not. The special order price should cover your variable cost. Yeah. First of all, the quantity should be there in your excess capacity. Second one, the special order price should be there to cover your variable cost. Third point is that, is there any relevant cost related to this? Relevant cost means a special order pricing may sometimes have to, you know, we may have to incur on, you know, the designing or delivery, then customs, etc. And the fourth point is a non-financial item. Whether this special order pricing is affecting our customer base, existing customer base. This new customer who is buying from you at a lower price may become competitor to the existing customer. Then existing customer is in doubt that how can my competitor buy goods at my cost price? He is buying from you at 250 and this customer is buying from you at 200. So obviously, even if he adds a profit of 230, he'll be selling at 230. Whereas this customer who has been purchasing from you for the years, adding a $30, same $30 profit, see, but he has to sell at 280 to get $30 profit per unit. To get $30 per unit, he has to sell, just only sell at 230, which is not even the cost price of the other customer. So this may spoil the existing business. In our decision analysis, we discussed so far the special order pricing. And the second decision is based on make or buy. In a sense, we are manufacturing some goods in-house, and now we are deciding that whether we should still continue manufacturing the same goods, or if there is a supplier, we can buy from outside and sell. But when we say that we are manufacturing, you might have incurred lots of sunk cost on machinery, plant, depreciation, license, etc., right? So what happened to the cost which is already incurred? Okay, so whether we have sunk cost, avoidable costs, which can be avoided by buying from outside. And the next point, non-financial issue, what you need to think is, okay, instead of making them in-house, it is better to buy from outside. But non-financial issues like trade secrets. So our supplier knows that how to manufacture these goods, what are the ingredients used, or you know, you may know who is our customer also sometimes when he gives delivery to directly to the customer. Second important point, a non-financial factor is that, what is the guarantee that the supplier will supply the goods on time? He may accept the order now, but after 6 months when you close down your manufacturing unit, he may supply the goods on not on time. And he may not give the importance to the quality of the goods. So these are the non-financial factors you need to consider. First, when you take a make or buy decision, first thing what you need to do is, what is the cost that is avoidable? Sunk cost, avoidable cost, unavoidable cost, etc. Second point, what we need to do is, what is the price? What is the manufacturing price in-house? What is the price offered by the supplier? Compare the prices. Third point is that whether the supplier has capacity to produce this or not. So financial, non-financial issues. Two, whether the supplier can produce the goods, trade secrets, then quality matters. This you need to mention in non-financial factors. One, two, three. In make or buy decisions, first of all, what we need to know is the what is the total cost of producing the goods. I give an abstract here that I am producing 20,000 units with a cost of 28 per unit, in which I have direct material, direct labor, variable overhead. Obviously, when I buy from outside, I can avoid material cost, labor cost. But in the case of variable overheads and fixed overheads, what can be avoided? What can be avoided that you need to investigate? Say, for example, you are buying at 20 from outside. 20,000 chips, the supplier is ready to supply at 25. When you just blindly compare the manufacturing cost and the purchase price, you may say, yes, better to buy from outside. No, investigate what cost can be avoided from overheads. Say, for example, fixed overhead will not be avoided. In that case, out of $28, what you can avoid is only direct material, direct labor, and variable overhead. But this cannot be avoided. Now let us investigate whether we should buy from outside or make in-house. Now here, what is avoidable cost? The avoidable cost is material, labor, and variable overhead. Now, when you avoid this from your total cost of manufacturing in-house, you are avoiding 15. Then, so 13 is still there. And how much you are buying from outside? 25. 25 plus this 13 is still incurred, so 38. When you manufacture in-house, it is 28. When you buy from outside, though you are buying at 25, but still avoidable cost that cannot be avoided is still there. That's the reason why the cost of producing one unit is, you know, increased to now 38. Therefore, not to be purchased from outside, because you have unavoidable costs.